All right, good evening, everyone, and welcome to Trinity College as we settle in for some women's ice hockey, a non-conference matchup tonight between Manhattanville and Trinity. Pretty good one here. Manhattanville off to a pretty good start as they come off a win over Newman by the score of 5-1. Overall, their record at 3-1-1, 3-0 in the UCHS, and for Trinity, coming off a loss, 4-1 to Norwich, number 7 Norwich, so a high-quality program they went up against. The Bantams coming in at 1-1, and they have not played a league contest yet in the NASCAC. Making her first start of the season for Trinity, between the pipes of the Bantams tonight will be Stephanie Garvis, and in goal for Manhattanville College will be Lena Flores, only a freshman out of Chicago, Illinois, and Stephanie Garvis out of Lincoln, Massachusetts, so she's making her first start, is the freshman Garvis. So, interesting matchup here tonight. Bantams in their home white jersey tops. Manhattanville coming to town in their all blue uniforms with the white numerals. Face off to come out at center. Cave Hawkins will take the draw for the home team, the Bantams, to get this one underway, and the puck will come to the near wall. So nice to have you with us here at Trinity at this gorgeous location. Puck control set up ahead. Will be inflated off to the far wall. Battle for it at the blue line. Both these teams are here early, going through their pregame preparations in a very excited fashion. Tamina played it back to the line right side. Good play over to Julia Lee. Near side it comes to Fusco. Fusco plays it into the circle. Taken there by Pepis. Pepis couldn't do much with it, and it's taken away by Manhattanville, and they try to roam up ahead. Into the zone comes James. James looks at the middle, got an open player, and that pass along, and it's off the stick of Kettlewood, and taken right back by the Bantams, trying to work it out of their zone, and they'll shovel it out to center ice. Scoreless here in the early going. That's Lee on the far side, maneuvering through. Over that red line, we'll drop it in and look for the line change. Back on it is Holly Meredith in her own zone. Had the puck swiped off her stick on a good forecheck by Sierra Lee. Now it's into the high slot, and Lee with a shot blocked away. So Lee stayed right with it. Players knocked down in the play. Comes off the near side here, and Martinson centering pass is deflected out toward the blue line. Hurrying after it there is Von Steinberg. Played it back to the corner. So some good action by the Bantams in the offensive end, and they keep it in the zone, the pressure on. This is Flaherty. Flaherty top of the circle, tried to drive on through, and the puck was stolen away by Meredith on a fine defensive effort and played up ahead to Janet Zook. Puck into the zone. Sticked away by Skull on the far side, and the Bantams were trying to clear it out, and Illibi's angle pass trying to get it out of the zone was nearly stolen away by DeFusco. No harm done as Manhattanville looking for a line change and a free opportunity for the Bantams. They work it quickly to the red line at center where it's intercepted by Ham. Ham knocked down as she tried to cut across the line. He got a whistle up and the game first penalty, and it's going to go against the Bantams for tripping. And we'll see the Manhattanville power play for the first time here today. Olive Skull going to the sin bin. 2 minutes for trip. Faceoff will come down inside the Bantam zone to the left of the freshman goaltender, Stephanie Garvis. So first opportunity to watch this power play unit for Manhattanville here tonight. Comes back to the line of Lopez. Lopez played it off left side. They work it patiently high slot, creeping in and firing a shot through was Pelowitz, and was stopped nicely and sent down ice. So Garvis with her first touch, and down the other end, Flores gets a chance to cover and touch the puck for the first time. Likewise, faceoff will come down inside the Manhattanville zone. A couple of players to take a look at here tonight who should be outstanding. Amanda Sabia leading Manhattanville in scoring with 6 goals and 1 assist, 7 points overall. Deanna Lopez has chipped in with a goal and 5 assists. And on the flip side for Trinity, Von Steinberg's 2 goals, and Cassidy McNeely with a goal and an assist to lead the way. They need to fix the penalty clock It didn't wind down with a drop of the puck. 17:32 remaining here in the first period. Manhattanville is on the power play. NASCAC standings. Middlebury off to a good start. They're 2-0. Amherst 1-1. Hamilton 1-1. Wesleyan is 0-2 in women's ice hockey play. Connecticut College at 0-2. Trinity yet to play one. Bowden and Colby also rounding out the standings. And they continue to work on the clock down below here in the early going. Nice to have you with us. They'll get it fixed sooner or later. Taking a look at the Trinity schedule. As we mentioned, they're coming in with a win and a loss. A nice win 5-0 over Johnson and Wales. That 4-1 loss to number 7 Norwich. Now a chance here versus Manhattanville. Scoreless here in the first period. The win for Trinity came here at home, season opener on Friday, November 15th, by the score of 5-0. And they're still having some problems with the penalty clock. For Manhattanville, they played to a tie against Johnson and Wales if you're looking for a common opponent, and then they dropped one to Johnson and Wales by the score of 4-2. They've strung away three consecutive wins as they find their skating legs here in the early part of this collegiate hockey season. We're on the power play, 1:30 remaining on that power play. Helowitz trying to drive it to the back wall, and she does. Quickly on it defensively as Simpson tried to play it up the board that was stolen away. Pass snapped off into the circle, shot to the short side off the stick of Lopez, and the save is made by Garbus. Nice job by Garbus to make the save there off of Lopez, who's dangerous from the blue line. Coming in with a goal and 5 assists, one of the playmakers. Bantams will change their penalty killing unit, and the faceoff will come down to the left of Garbus. Out there to take the draw is Lee. Lee shovels it to the wall. Steinbergs couldn't get it out. Lopez kept it and goes cross ice on the pass. Pelowitz back to Lopez. Angled one through the slot. Deflected away. Captured by Capone and banged off the wall and down ice. 60 seconds remaining on the power play for Manhattanville. Scoreless here in the first period of play. They'll wind it up in their own zone. Pelowitz with a long pass along the wall. Tipped down ice by Sabia. Stopped behind the net there by Garvis. Garvis will play it to space. Going to be stolen away. Manhattanville with a chance to set their power play here in the waning moments. There's a shot. Blocked away off a stick as Allie Howard tried to drive one through. And it slipped over the glove of Howard and down into that Manhattanville zone. On it there is Meredith. Holly Meredith from behind the net. 30 seconds remaining on the power play. Could be their final rush up the ice. Puck comes loosely out to center ice. Ham skates after it to the left circle. Looks in front. Curls into the corner. Plays a nice backhand pass back to Meredith. Meredith will hold. Got it on to James. Lost it in the slot. Stolen there. And Cave Hawkins got it out to center ice with just 8 seconds remaining on the Manhattanville penalty. So good job. Now you got a trip upcoming here to Manhattanville and a power play chance upcoming for the Bantams. This will be a hooking call. And into the sin bin here to the near side, down to our left from our vantage point, is Holly Meredith. So good job by the Trinity College Bantam special teams on the penalty kill as they shut down the Manhattan power play. Now they get a chance on a power play in their own right. Taking the face off will be Sierra Lee. She'll log a lot of ice time here today for the Bantams. Out there to take the draw is Sabia for Manhattanville. Gallant will win the draw back after Meredith finds some open ice and scales it on down. Garvis will set it up behind the net. This is McNeely from behind. Through the faceoff circles and rambles up ice. Carries along off the right side. That's actually von Steinberg, number 26 and not 25, with that jersey all wrinkled up. Into the corner, good work there by Lee. Got it back to the line. Lee's going to get a pass from Martson. Lee's pass into the slot is intercepted and played out to center ice. So good anticipation, fine defensive work there by Zoe Pelowitz. Back into the zone, rushing off the right side. Lee got it into the high slot. Martson steps in. That shot just deflected wide. On the rebound, Sierra Lee back to the line. By Steinberg shot, and that whistled off a skate and just wide of goal. A good hard shot from the blue line. Power play producing opportunities with 60 seconds left. First power play chance of the game here for the Bantams. Puck back to the line. Von Steinberg to control, trying to work a little give and go, but they come back midpoint to Martson. Shot through a screen again, just wide of net. Dug away and taken by Flaherty. Smooth pass back to Martson. Martson goes cross ice. Work the perimeter quite effectively, do the Bantams, and back to the line. Von Steinberg puts it right side, right onto the tape of Lee. Shot goes to the top of the goal mouth. Into the corner goes Flaherty. Flaherty trying to maintain possession, stolen away and sent down by Tiana Lopez. With just 23 seconds remaining on the Bantam power play. It's been a good one. They've had shots towards net. Just haven't found the back of the net as of yet. Their final rush up ice. Good pass to the near side. Carried in. And played on behind. Savinia did a nice job there on the carry up ice. Now Simpson plays it over. One timer blocked away as Savina tried to drive that one through a pair of skates. Now she pinches along the wall. Gets some good help there from Wilhelmsen. Played on the Fusco. Penalty time has expired and both teams are back at even strength. There's a shot going, whistling wide off the stick of Kobian and to the far side. Kept in off the skate of Simpson. Simpson wearing the C on the jersey proudly for the Bantams here in 2019-20. 13 minutes remaining in the period. Puck nearly worked into the slot by Wilhelmsen. It's stolen away and knocked out to center ice. Simpson quickly on it, played it onto the left wing side to Fusco. Fusco into the circle, shot, hit a maze of bodies. It's underneath the fallen Bantam, and it's scraped away as Wilhelmsen just couldn't find a stick with a white jersey top. Puck back down inside the Bantam end. Trinity College at even strength on the ice now with Manhattanville. Clark will send it down. Stopped by Garvis behind the net. Garvis has been very active coming out of her goal and setting things up. Little turnover. Quick shot by Clark, and she only got a piece of it, and it was quickly skated away by McKeon down the right wing. McKeon into the zone of the backhand side. Looks in front. Her pass is deflected to the near corner. Five players scrumming after that loose puck. Taken away by Meredith. Snapped the pass up ice to Fusco. Trying to maneuver on through the back check of Hoare will stop her travel. And here comes Clark. Clark will break in down the left wing side. Lost a handle to it to Julia Lee. Puck reversed near wall. And played out to center ice. Manhattanville trying to mount the attack. Broken up. Lushenko got it cross ice and into that Manhattanville zone. First one on it is Holly Meredith, played it on behind the net. Her defense partner, Martinietti, lost control of it as it comes to the line. Kept in by Capone, played on behind the net. Bantam doing a good job controlling play right now. Camille von Steinberg, a shot is blocked away. Von Steinberg throws it in on goal and the save made by Lena Flores, and she'll hold for the faceoff. So good first period here for the Bantams. They're carrying the action. It's still scoreless, however. Each team has had a power play chance here in the first period. It's great to be back in a nice hockey rink once again. It's been a long time. Faceoff upcoming. Janet Zhu to take it for Manhattanville. Went up against Cave Hawkins at the shot. Could hear the pad save made by the goalkeeper Flores down below off the Van Steinberg shot. Up ice comes Nash. Nash will drop it halfway into the zone. Puck into the corner and a great back check here by Cave Hawkins as Karina hustling after it. Now down the right wing side she comes. Carries up over the red line at center and poked off her stick. And back the other way comes Zhu. Zhu with a shot on. That sticked away by Garbus of the corner. Midway through this first period of play, still scoreless. Long pass off to the right wing side. Carried along by Pepis. Pepis into the corner, puts the brakes on. Buys some space, fanned on her pass attempt. Now it's into the corner to Martson. Martson rolls up the wall and plays it back to the line. And it's off the stick of Simpson and out to center ice. And DeFusco has it. She's all alone. She'll drop and look for the line change. Back in her own end. Simpson will play it up ahead. Pass quickly tipped on to Lee. Lee from the circle shot off the blocker of Flores to the far side. Creeping in his skull. Can't keep it in the zone. But she got some help. Backing up the play was Martson. Martson plays it to the back wall. Great work there by Martson when she saw her defenseman pinch. Very alert play. Puck kept in on the forecheck by Flaherty. Flaherty trying to work it on with her teammate. That's deflected back towards the line. Bornstein controlled it just momentarily. Now they go midpoint with a pass to Skull. Skull plays it diagonally back into the corner. Collected there by Kaylin Flaherty. Trying to work it back to the line. It's out to center ice. Julia Lee slows down the Manhattanville breakout. Now it's flipped over her head, and then Julia Lee will go back after it over the goal line extended to the backboard. Quickly plays it up ice. Get it on to Bornstein into the zone. Bornstein trying to tiptoe through. She does. Centering pass, and that is deflected away onto the tape of McKeon. Pass into the high slot to Hoare. She fell down as he tried to pull the trigger, and back the other way comes Manhattanville. Lopes trying to carry along. Ran into a crowd, and the puck sent back out to center ice. Down to 8 minutes, 55 seconds remaining here in the first period, still scoreless. Bennett to Tanning with both teams with opportunities here. Lopez with a steal, it's a 3-on-1. Cross-ice pass, they got the numbers. They look for Lopez, pass to Lopez, she scores! Well, Lopez stole that puck at neutral ice, and she kept chugging along, and she'll put it home for the tally. That was a beautiful feed off the stick of Sabia to set it all up. So you got a 1-0 score. Time of that goal, some 11 minutes in. So 1-0. Lopez with the goal, her first of the year. Sabia picking up the helper. Time of the goal officially 11 minutes and 17 seconds. So a turnover at neutral ice, and the Bantons paid the price. Back to the line off the right side to Capone. Capone will play it up the wall. Collected by Wilhelmsen. Her shot on, and the save is made by Lena Flores. She's been sharp here in the early going. She has seen most of the action. So officially, Sabia with the help on the Lopez goal, her first of the season. Shots on goal in favor of Manhattanville, 5-4 at this time. Faceoff win by Trinity College. It's played to the back wall. Skipped over the stick of Sierra Lee. Chased down on the far side by Flaherty. Back to Lee into the corner. Lee got tangled up with a couple of blue jersey defenders, and it's taken away. Sent up ahead. And down ice it goes off the stick of Clark, and it's going to be covered by Garvis for a faceoff. So 1-0 is score. Manhattanville with the lead. Trinity College making a change. McCabe Hawkins line is out there. Faceoff win back. when Steinberg played it immediately to the near wall. Cross ice pass off the stick of Fusco found its mark, and it's sent on down by Pepis, and she'll give it a chase. First one on it, on behind the net. Pepis carries into the corner, looks at the blue line, pass on. When Steinberg's shot will flutter up high and off the glove, perhaps, of Flores, and we get a whistle. Official on the far side blowing the whistle, perhaps a high stick on that shot that was up high. They're going to call a faceoff outside the zone. 7:26 remaining here in the first period. Should go all the way down, right? Let's see. That's going to be just outside the zone. Not allowing Manhattanville to make a change was the back official. Four officials on the ice surface here tonight. This is Hawkins into the high slot through traffic. Shot on Flores. Glove save. Nice stick handling by Karina. Gave Hawkins and had a chance there. Karina, a junior out of Edgewater, Maryland, has played 48 career games with 4 goals and 7 assists, a total of 11 points. She'll take the faceoff here. Off the draw, puck back to the line. Simpson drops it off the backboard. Puck took a funny bounce, and it allows Meredith to send it on down. Stinson to give it a chase. Got a forechecker on her back. That's Ham. Stinson able to zig and zag away. Played up off the stick of Pepis and down ice. No icing to be called, and it's chased down by Holly Meredith. Meredith got tied up along the boards. Puck stolen by Fusco. Fusco walks in front, the backhander, and Flores held her ground and covers for yet another faceoff. 6:44 remaining here in the first period. The Bantams will change a couple of their players. Flaherty's going to step onto the ice along with Martson. Sierra Lee in the middle. Foy on the blue line along with number 17, Alex Simpson. Puck out to center ice. Taylor Foy over to her teammate. That's Simpson. Ran into a logjam on the far side, stays with it, and filtered it down into the Manhattanville zone. Collected there by Allie Howard. That's played off the skate. Martson's pass dribbled in front. They hit a goalpost. A rebound. Miraculous stop by Flores. Oh, they had the chances there. Lee and company just flat out robbed. Well, they got the bounce of the puck they were looking for. And they nearly lit the lamp. Flaherty had a chance at it out front. Lee did likewise. Still 1-0 Manhattanville here in the first. The Ballants doing their job. Puck on behind the net. Pelowitz got spun around. Two on the forecheck for the Bantams. Playing aggressively, down by one here at home. Manhattanville will find some open space. Again, they're trying to create some numbers with that long stretch pass, and they have a 2-on-1. The pass across is deflected, and then deflected away again is Sabia, who picked up a beautiful assist, tried to work it in front. Now it's under his stick. Played it on smartly. Side of the goal. Lopez just could not find good shooting position there. Now it's collected by Martson and played down ice. Chased down by Flaherty. Flaherty carries behind the net, looking for some help. Martin Yeti stays with her. Puck played side of the goal. Skips along to Zoe Pelowitz, and Zoe Pelowitz played it out to center ice where Julia Lee intercepts for the Bantams. Puck right in front of the Manhattanville bench. They're on the far side. The Bantams will sit down and rest directly below us. That's where their bench is. Puck out to center ice, and here they come again. Pass onto the right side to Lopez. Lopez had it poked away neatly there by Kobian, and it's off to the far side. Battle for it. Manhattanville will collect it. Puck played over the stick of Lopez. Chased down and working out of the zone. Mushenko. Mushenko down the left wing side. Karina Mushenko on behind goal. Looks in front. Nothing going on. Finds a defenseman creeping up. And a shot towards net. And again, Flores is there with company on the doorstep. She continues to shine here in the first period. Another shot. Another save. Well, Helmsen was looking for the rebound on that shot. When Steinbergs, who's had herself a heck of a game thus far, plays it off smartly. Back in front, and She got knocked down as she tried to pull the trigger. She was well guarded there by Taylor Hamm. Puck kept in by Skull at the line. Down under 4.5 minutes remaining here in the first period, and the puck played on. Sandilands played it out of the far side. Manhattanville will stretch it up ice again. Puck collected and winding up as McKeon. Now the pass comes near left. Forsteen tried to throw it through. It was deflected away. Manhattanville still trying to get it out of the zone, and this time they will. Sandilands will send it down and look for a line change. Good job there by the Valance to alleviate all that pressure deep in their own zone. Right now they're showing a good forecheck, disrupting the breakout. Ornstein able to move it out the center ice. It's driven right back in on the goalkeeper, Garvis. And Garvis leaves it off to the right side, the foy. They got an arm up and a delayed offside here against Manhattanville in the faceoff upcoming. 1-0 is score. The lone goal scored by Manhattanville in the first. Deanna Lopez with the assist going to Amanda Sabia. Time of the goal, 11 minutes and 17 seconds in period number one. Off the faceoff. Carried in by DeFusco. She got run off by Simpson. Simpson takes the pass on the reverse. Good smart play there by Foy, her defense partner. Cross ice pass off the stick of Clark and now collected by Pepis. Maneuvers through smartly. Plays to the far wall, carries into the zone. Pepis, good pass on, and a little stick check took it away from Dave Hopkins. Simpson trying to pinch to keep it in, could not. Back the other way comes Clark now. And offside is Manhattanville, a little too quick on that far wing. And a faceoff upcoming. 3:03 remaining here in the first period. This game started at 7:30 tonight. Nice to have you with us. Flaherty off the right wing. Pass in front. Lee tried to chop at it. It's going to be stolen away by Zoo and played up the center ice. This is DeFusco. Carries on to Clark. Clark, little maneuver along the wall. Shovels it to the corner and on behind. Julia Lee there to save the day and play it onto the near side here. Cabina played it up the center ice and on down. No icing to be called. This is Zoe Pelowitz. As the Bantams will change their forward line. Three fresh forwards out in the ice. They create a turnover at mid-ice. Quickly backed up, however, by Taylor Hamm. Hamm off to the left wing. Tried to circle away from the on-rushing defenders. It's taken away as the Bantams did a nice job just holding their blue line and sent on down ice off the stick of Ushenko. Ushenko on the forecheck, trying to get some help down there from McNeely. Puck goes to the far side. Players will battle for it. Wilhelmson, where's the lucky number 13 on the back of the jersey? This is McNeely. Good job along the boards. Moved it on to Moshenko. Moshenko played it back to the line. When Steinberg's shot nearly snuck through, just getting a pad on it was Flores. Back to the line. Capone kept it in. Couldn't get it deep, however, and it's shoveled back out the center ice and taken away. Manhattanville's Lopez across the line, got it on, and there's a quick shot. Save made again by Garvis. Good job by Garvis. That loose puck was picked up. He had to be alert. And it was Sabia who had the chance. Puck down deep into the Manhattanville zone, just above a minute remaining here. A quickly moving first period of play, and it certainly has been entertaining here tonight. Nice crowd making their way into the facility. Puck stolen away. Centering pass in front. Chopped at Flores. Flashes a pad. Dave Hopkins tried to unleash one there. Didn't get much on it, but Flores still had to be quick to make the save in tight, and the puck sent back out to center ice and Taylor Foy on it. Foy will send it through a maze of players and back down into the Manhattanville zone. Chased down by Lanny Nash. He's being bothered along the boards there by Martha Pepis as Pepis does a heck of a job on the forecheck. Now, Zoo to control, reverses it near corner, taken there by Sandilands and played it out to center right. Battle for it right at the Manhattanville blue line. Players now all bunched up together. Coming out of the crowd is Sierra Lee. Pass off to Pepis on the right, back to Lee, into her skates. He spins, fires a shot, another save by Flores. Came out top of the crease and made the stop there. And the puck back down inside the Trinity zone, and that's going to do it for the first period of play. So the first period comes to a close. Very exciting first period. Unofficial shots on goal totals for Trinity 11 and 5 for Manhattanville in the period. Each team went 0 for 1 on their power play chances. Manhattanville did a nice job in front of their goaltender Flores as they blocked 5 shots, 1 block for Trinity. And to recap the scoring for you, at 11:17 of the first period, the only goal scored by Tiana Lopez, her first of the season, with the assist going to Amanda Sabia. All right, we'll rest the vocal cords. The Zamboni is going to do some work, and we'll be back with second period action for you in just a few here at Trinity College in Hartford, Connecticut. All right, back here at the Williams Rink from the Williams family back in 1964, taking a look at some of the first period stats for you. 1-0 Manhattanville with the lead over Trinity College. Game started at 7:30 here tonight. The only goal at even strength at 11:17 by Tiana Lopez. Amanda Sabia, who had really had a very good first period, picked up the helper on the score, the only goal of the game. Each team 0-for-1 on their power play opportunities in the first period. Shots on goal, the official totals for Trinity College, a total of 13 for Manhattanville. Total of 7 shots on goal. In the faceoff category, Manhattanville won 8 and lost 7. Amanda Sabia with 5 faceoff wins to lead the way. Janet Zhu won 3. Leading the way, Sierra Lee with 3 face-off wins for Trinity. Obviously, face-off wins so important for possession of the puck and a chance to either move it up ice or apply pressure if it's in the offensive end. So Gavin's in her first 20 minutes. Did a heck of a job. Lena Flores was outstanding, stopping all 13 shots she faced in the first period. And Garvis stopped 6 of 7. Officials are back on the ice surface. We're ready for period number 2. Teams will be making their appearance in just a moment. After today's game versus Manhattanville, third consecutive home game, by the way, for the Bantams. 1-1 thus far. They play Connecticut College right here next Friday night, the 22nd of November. Then they travel to Connecticut College, their first away game of the season. They'll make another trip to Salem State, Salem, Massachusetts, on Friday, December 6th. Next matchup for Manhattanville will be at Lebanon Valley. Then they play at Chatham before they have a chance to host Connecticut College and St. Anselm in the early part of December. Holiday season is upon us. Bantams down below coming out energized for their head coach. Keith Maurice in his 5th season. David Turco, the head coach of Manhattanville, out of American International, in his 9th year. The men's team from AIC pulled a major upset in NCAA hockey playoff action just a year ago, you might remember, knocking out the number 1 seed. Flores will defend down to our right, Garvis to our left. Face off to come at center to start the second period at even strength. Hawkins able to win it to the far side. Carried into the corner when Steinberg on behind the net. Comes into the right circle. She's a good skater. Centers it in front and Hawkins just couldn't put a stick to it, and it's quickly swept back out to center ice. Collected there by Capone. Capone's going to retreat into her own zone. Played it off smartly to Karina Hawkins. Hawkins coming down the right wing side into the zone. Looking for the trailer. Dropped it off to Pepis. Pepis centering pass, and Flores sticked it away. Turned back up ice by Manhattanville. Lopez, the goal scorer in the game, worked at the center where it's intercepted by Cave Hawkins and sent on in. And she looks for the line change. Good shift there by the center iceman. Puck knocked out the center ice. But Steinberg's gamble to get after it. Sabia now trying to reach a loose puck. Knocked away to the back wall. Skull will quickly bang it up ahead. Let me correct myself. That was Kobinia sending it on down. This is Meredith. Played it out to the far corner. Comes right back to Meredith on the near side. Outlet pass. Finds its way to center. Taken by Zhu. Down the left wing. Zhu looking for a trailer and finds one. Back to Zhu. It comes on the give and go. And it's centered in front and knocked away. They had an opportunity to Fusco trying to work in collaboration with Zhu. Puck on behind. Taken by DeFusco. DeFusco locked up along the wall. Wiggles through a couple of players and had it slapped off for his stick, and back the other way comes McNeely. McNeely cuts across the line. That little cut, I thought it might have put the wingmates offside, but it did not. Bantams have it in the offensive end. Shot to a screen, and that hit the crossbar. Well, Helmsen just hit a crossbar and a shot to a screen that Alina Flores never saw. Puck rattled out of play. Faceoff will remain in the Manhattanville zone. Milan's got lucky there. Sierra Lee to take the draw. Going up against Janet Zhu. Off the faceoff. Collected by Lee. Lee turning in the corner. Locked up by Nash. Played it on behind the net to Flaherty. Flaherty had it poked off for his stick. Puck pops free to the near side to Nash. Nash trying to work it out of the zone for Manhattanville. Now Zhu on it. Got bottled up. The forecheck of Lee will take it away. Puck just slid right under the stick of Lee as she tried to get a return pass. Flaherty able to dig after it, keep it in. Tapped along by Marston behind the net. To the far side, Sandilands. Played it to the blue line, but couldn't get it out. Sandilands will try again. In her far right face-off circle. Being hounded there by Flaherty. Nearly stole it away. Puck shovel behind the net to Nash and quickly played to the blue line and poked out to center ice down the left wing side. Good job there by DeFusco. Got it across the blue line, and Clark will just tap it down and look for a line change for the Blondes. Long stretch pass to center ice. Intercepted by Martignetti. Stick went flying way up in the air. That was the stick of number three, Tina Martignetti. And the Bantam trying to apply pressure down the other end. Little nudge along the wall by Bornstein. Puck played to the glove of Capone. Capone played it behind the net. Collected there by Pelowitz. Pelowitz has logged a lot of ice time here tonight. Couldn't get it out of the zone. Shot hit some sticks in front. Tapped away from Hoare. Trying to go after it. To the far side, that's Panza. Centering pass comes off the wall, and that's intercepted. And a good start here by the Bantams offensively with their forecheck. That's Howard, able to propel it down ice to the far side. Bornstein to hunt it down. Taken away on a forecheck, quick shot on, save made by Garvis. Kept in by Meredith. Meredith tees it up and drives a shot off the shin guard of Cave Hawkins. Cave Hawkins on it, played it on behind the net. Good play there to Bornstein. Bornstein finds an open player on the left, that's Fusco, and Fusco across the red line, now across the blue line. Fusco weaving into the circle. Fusco comes up the wall to the hash mark, played it on to her teammate. That's Pepis. Pepis rounds the net, turns, high slot, quick shot, score! Might have been deflected off a skate near, but the Bantams have tied it here in the first. 4:03, time of the goal. Let's see if there'll be an assist maker on that one. Martha Pepis. Great job there. So the Bantams have tied it at one. And for Pepis, who's 5'2", a junior out of Lincoln, Rhode Island, that's her second goal of the season, her third point overall. This is her 53rd career game. She hadn't scored their first 50. Back the other way because Manhattanville on the rush up ice off the faceoff. Just couldn't connect with a pass in front. So 1-1 your score. This is Lopez. The goal scorer for Manhattanville. Played it off to the far side. Sabia got turned back. Now Sabia along the wall. Kicked it deep into their own zone. Her teammate Lopez. And they got it on back. Pelowitz played it quickly ahead. Now it's deflected off the stick of Lopez as she looks for line change. 1-1 your score. Manhattanville led it after 1-1 nothing. The Bantam have just tied it with an even strength score of their own. Well, Helmsen, who hit a crossbar on their last shift out there, just turned it over to Zhu. Zhu centered it, quickly sticked away to the far side. McNeely trying to chase it down. Maneuvers up over the blue line. Contested by two Manhattanville defenders, and she'll turn it over. Back the other way, DeFusco. DeFusco, her pass to Sabia, and the whole thing is offside. Face-off upcoming. 1-1 your score, 14-41 remaining here in the second period of play. Well, the action has been exciting today. Trinity goal by Pepis. Fusco will pick up the helper. 4:03 time of the tally here in the second. We got a 1-1 game. Each team has been penalized once back in the first. Both teams are 0-for-1 in their power play tries tonight. This is Nash, played it up ahead. Zhu trying to fight through two defenders, got tied up by Taylor Foy nicely in a little knot. Sendelin's in her own zone. Played it off to the far side. Foy would challenge, taken away by Mushenko. Mushenko couldn't do much with it, and Manhattanville played it on down. Icing's been waved off. Puck near side. Ethel Wilhelmsen played it off. The Foy snapped a pass into the skates of her teammate, trying to find it there was Lee. It was a difficult task to control that puck. Julia Lee in the corner. Got some help. Sierra Lee trying to work it up ice. Got tangled up with her own teammate there. Dropped down to the ice was Mushenko. Bantams recover. Played on to Wilhelmsen. Try to get it out. Meredith will poke it to keep it in. High slot. Ham had it hop over his stick and back the other way come the Bantams. Sierra Lee gaining speed into the zone. Lee sweeps down low. The backhander and the save made by Lena Flores. Nifty little play there by Sierra Lee. 13:26 remaining here in the second. We got a 1-1 game. Face-off will come to the left of Flores. Flores out of Chicago, went to Guerin College Prep. Freshman's only 5'2", so a pair of freshman goalkeepers manning the nets tonight at each end. Lee tried to fight in front, got knocked down as she tried to pull the trigger. Back the other way comes Taylor Ham, snaps a pass into the middle. Defenseman Pelowitz stepping up into the offense, back into the skates of Ham. Ham tried to dangle it through, and it just swept away by Kamelli von Steinberg. She does a nice job, and she buys some space. Good skater out of the zone, down the right wing side, lugs it in. Snaps a shot on, save made by Flores, rebound to the corner. Von Steinberg will get it right back into the circle. Tried to get the shot away, and that was muffled and taken by Taylor Hammond, played back out to center. Karina Cave Hawkins on it there. Tried to turn it to the far wall. Runs through a little bump along the boards. Did a nice job there. Puck in the air. Skull trying to keep it in, and it's knocked back out to center ice. And we got a penalty upcoming. Tripping call for the awkward fall on the far side. And it's going to go against the Bantams. Second time, Olive has gone to the sin bin here tonight, and second power play chance upcoming for Manhattanville. So Skull into the penalty box for the second time, both for tripping. Cave Hawkins, a good face-off lady, out there to take the draw. Looks like she was going up against, could have been Kettlewood, couldn't read the number with a ponytail there. That's the biggest challenge when you're calling women's hockey, is deciphering the number with that long hair hanging out of the helmet. Good job by the Bantams as they win the faceoff and send it down, forcing Manhattanville to work the length of the ice. Good cross-ice pass to Lopes. Lopes carries into the zone, picks up the trailer. That's Sabian. It's poked off her stick. She gets it on back. Played it on to Tittman. Tittman back to Lopes. Fusco able to harass her, takes it away and carries down ice. Toe drag and stays with it. Great job on the penalty kill by Mia Fusco and played it back into the corner. Well done by Fusco. Gets a little rattle on the helmet from her teammates as she steps back over the boards and onto the bench. Puck dropped on. Sabia played it to the corner. Back to Sabia, high slot, quick shot, and what a save. Stephanie Garvis with her finest of the night as she predicted that shot from Sabia and cut down the angle. Beautiful play with 1:01 remaining on the power play here for the Valiants. 11:30 remaining here in the second period, nearly midway through this hockey contest, tied at 1. Lopes scored in the first period. They give Manhattanville a 1-0 lead, and Martha Pepys has tallied here in the second for the Bantams of Trinity College. Puck played in the line. Good job by Pelowitz to keep it in. Comes back to the defenseman Pelowitz, and that shot is deflected and knocked back out to center ice, chased down by Allie Howard. Howard to the far wall. Bounce it along, will give it a chase. Howard, strong on her skates, plays it to the corner, got tied up there by Von Steinberg. Got another penalty upcoming here, the arm is up. And it's gonna be a slashing call, and it's gonna go against Allie Howard, and this will even things up on the ice surface for the next 32 seconds. We'll see 4-on-4. And then the abbreviated power play for the Bantams. For some 1:28 of penalty time, the faceoff will be all the way down inside the Manhattanville zone in this 1-1 game. Well, the scoreboard now lit up like a Christmas tree here at the Williams Rink. Faceoff coming to the right-hand side of Lena Flores. 4-on-4 in front of the goaltenders for the next 30 seconds. Back to the line, Julia Lee, and it's knocked out to center ice by Taylor Hamm, who hunted it down quickly. Puck swept onto the far side. Bantams trying to maneuver on in. This is Sierra Lee, and shot on and save made by Flores, and she'll cover. 17 seconds remaining on the 4-on-4, and then the Bantams will get that power play for about a minute 28. Cassidy McNeely stepping onto the ice. Von Steinberg will stay on the ice surface for the Bantams, along with Martson as her partner. Back to the line it comes. Von Steinberg plays it off. Martson able to play it to the corner. Held onto by Lee. Back to Martson, shot deflected. Lee digging after it. Check that. That's actually McNeely going after that loose puck, 25. He had Sierra Lee on the doorstep. 3-on-2. Back the other way. Shot. Garvis makes a stop on a redirect and a rebound. Carried on behind goal. Again, that was Sabia creeping behind everybody. Now it's stolen side of the net. But Lopes couldn't pull the trigger. Power play is underway for the Bantams, but right now they're a bit disorganized. Kaylin Flaherty carries it to the left wing side. Flaherty, dipsy doodles, through one, and it's torn off her stick. Von Steinberg's there to back up the play. On the Lee, she wants off the ice after a long shift. She'll dump it down. 49 seconds remaining on the power play here for the Bantams. They'll have to start deep in their defensive zone. Simpson will chase it down behind the net. Comes out immediately to the right side through a slice of the circle. Open ice over the red line. Carries into the zone smartly. Oh, offside was a wingmate on the left. With 33 seconds remaining on the power play. So Manhattanville now 0-for-2 in their power play opportunities tonight. And the Bantams getting close to that number two. 1-1 your score. Been entertaining thus far. Nice crowd on hand enjoying the action on a Tuesday night. Third consecutive home game for the Bantams. They're 1-1 here at home, looking for their second win of the season. Now, one of the officials over there talking to the coaching staff of Manhattanville. Turco with 105 wins in his coaching career 92 losses and 22 ties. Off the faceoff. Bushenko carries in, gets shouldered off the puck. Power play continues down to 24 seconds remaining. Breaking through is Hawkins. Hawkins will carry to the wall. Got it back to the line. Pass snapped on. Bushenko sent it across the goal mouth. Collected by Williamson. Williamson played it back. Kavinia with a shot, deflected away. Back out of the right point to Simpson. Played it halfway up the wall. Kavinia will get it back. Quick release with a wrister down low. And somehow Flores found that with a good screen set in front by Wilhelmsson. Both teams are back at even strength. Wilhelmsson the control. Got it back to the line left side. Kavinia goes cross ice. Now they tip it back to Simpson. Simpson with a shot. Chopped down in front. Comes back to Simpson. Simpson hustles after it and played it to the corner. And on behind. Taken here by Martinietti. Martinietti with the head up. Carries across the red line at center, rushes over the blue line, threw it up off the body of Simpson. Simpson will take it away and cuts in front of own net. Now weaves out to the right wing side and carries on. She'll reach the red line and drop it down and look for a line change. Martinson from behind the net now. Top of the circle. Laid it off left side. And Steinsberg put it in front off the stick of Fusco and deflects right back. When Steinsberg to control again. Back to Fusco. Snapped it in front. That puck was deflected. Comes back to Fusco. Fusco the backhander. She elevates it up over the crossbar. Bantams have carried the play here in the period. Capone with a shot. Knocked down in front. Battle for it. Pepis the goal scorer to the far side. She's been pesky all night long. Puck thrown along to the near wall. Taken there. Moved up ice by Lanny Nash to center. That takes the pressure off. Manhattanville for just a moment as the Bantams will make a wholesale change. Long pass to the right wing side to the dangerous Tiana Lopez, and she'll drop it down inside the Bantam end as they bring out some fresh troops like what? Midway through this hockey game now and well beyond that. Through ice comes Flaherty. Flaherty across the line of the right circle. Flaherty stick handles to the corner, drops it on, poked at by Sierra Lee. Lee trying to stay with it. Puck is lofted to the far side on the forecheck Martinson, but it's knocked out to center and sneaking on behind on the right wing. It looks like perhaps James played it on behind the net. Taken by Lopez. Now it's stolen right back. Martinson goes wing to wing to the right. Flaherty in. Flaherty from the circle with a shot on, saved by Flores. Puck on behind the net. Collected there by Kettlewood. And she's hauled down. Got a penalty upcoming here. That was actually Lopez that was hooked down, number 12. And we'll see yet another penalty going against the Bantams. Third time they've been whistled here, so the third power play from Manhattanville. They're 0 for 2 as Kaylin Flaherty in the penalty box. 6:41 remaining here in the period. 1-1 your score. Pepis and Lopez, the goal scorers here tonight. Shots on goal, the unofficial totals. Trinity with 19, Manhattanville with 11. Off the faceoff, it comes back to Howard. Plays catcher to defense partner Meredith, and the shot flex off, escape to the far side, taken there by Ham. Laid it on behind the net, scraped away to the near side, hustled after it as a Kobinia. Tried to get it on out, she couldn't. Howard held her ground effectively. Into the corner goes Alex Simpson. Simpson will loft it past the stick of Howard, who batted at it there unsuccessfully. So if this was baseball or softball, her batting average would be zero. Up ice it comes, a Ham. Ham trying to stick handle through. Get tangled up there. Backing up the play. Nice job by Meredith. Blind backhand pass thrown away by Mushenko. Works into the zone. Mushenko looking. Fires. Save for a shorthanded bid. But Angelica Mushenko. Good penalty kill by the Bantams this time around. 1:12 remaining on the power play for Manhattanville. Faceoff coming deep in their own end. 5:52 remaining here in the period. 1-1 your score. Off the faceoff, puck out to center ice. Capone will control it, and Claudia being harassed, trying to move it away. That was Sabia who harassed her there, but good job by Capone to stay with it, and the puck will slide fortuitously out the center ice. This is Tiana Lopez. Played it up ahead and offside on the near side was Tittman, and another faceoff upcoming with 50 seconds remaining on the power play here for Manhattanville. Manhattanville in the away blue uniforms with the white numerals tonight, and the Bantams in their slick looking home uniforms, the white tops, got that gold and blue trim. Puck out to center ice. Lopez over. Pelowitz snapped a pass up into the middle. This is Tittman into the zone, poked off her stick, and puck knocked back the other way. Terrific work by Camille von Steinbergs. Again, he has been all over the ice surface. Very versatile player. This is Zoo. Now Pelowitz will scrape it down ice. Puck to the far side. Von Steinberg's on it. Whistled it to the line. Going to be gloved down and kept in. Good job there by Lopez. Pass on the doorstep, and Zoo tried to redirect it. Knocked it just wide with Garbus sitting deep in her crease, and yet another penalty upcoming here. Both teams are back at even strength now. And the penalty is going to go against Anna Tittman. So she's in the penalty box. Didn't get the call on that. But it'll be a two-minute power play now. Third of the game for the Bantams. They're 0 for 2 on their try. Bantams work the perimeter. Von Steinberg's from the blue line. Get it on. The lead. Midpoint shot. Knocked down in front. Rebound. Flores flashes a pad. Made a couple of saves. Flaherty had the chances. Martin let it go from the blue line. It created havoc. Madsen on the Flaherty. Flaherty. One-timer by Von Steinberg. The puck was dropped by Flores after the glove save. Now it's taken by Taylor Hamm and finds open space and sends it out to the Bantam blue line. Von Steinberg's on it. Full of energy into the zone. Into the circle. Sweeps down into the corner. Von Steinberg will lay it off. Taken there by Sierra Lee. Lee holding, played at midpoint. Martin over to the left side. Flaherty snaps off a shot, and that's blocked away. Von Steinberg's on it again. On to Sinston. Sinston played it on behind the net. Now back to Martin. Martin slap shot, save, rebound. Von Steinberg was spinning for it. Actually, that might have been McNeely. Yeah, indeed it was. Pass right through the stick of McNeely. Waiting on the doorstep there. Kept in by Flaherty into the high slot. Has some speed to the circle. Shot to his screen. Another stop made by Flores. Good-looking power play, but nothing to show for it. And finally, Manhattanville will just scale it down ice with 29 seconds remaining on the power play here. And in her own zone is Olive Skull. Played it up ahead of the right wing to Robinia. Robinia continues to carry into the high slot now. Got it on to the right wing side. Ushenko shot knocked down in front by Pelowitz, and puck cleared the center with just 3 seconds remaining on the penalty to Anna Tittman. She's out of the sin bin. Both teams are back at even strength. Both teams now 0 for 3 in their power play bids here tonight with 2.5 minutes remaining in the second period in the 1-1 game. Puck out to center. Wilhelmsen will find it. Into the zone with some speed. Carries behind the net. It tied up. Tried to turn away from the check. Stays with it. Wilhelmsen had it stolen away by Pelowitz, who's been very, very effective. Puck finds a stick of Julia Lee. Snaps it into the slot. Net hit a couple of sticks in its own right. Ushenko. Back to the line. Smart play. Foy tried to drive one through a maze of players, and that was blocked away by Pelowitz. Puck still inside that Manhattanville zone. Down under 2 minutes remaining in the period. Puck back out to center right. On it, Foy. Got pestered there. Puck played down into the corner. Looks like Sabia. We got a penalty upcoming here again to the Bantams. Hooking will be the call. And Taylor Foy will go to the penalty box. Fourth power play opportunity for Manhattanville coming up. 1-1, you score. Well, it's been a fun one thus far, hasn't it, folks? I hope you enjoyed the telecast. And stay with us for the third period. It should be exciting. This penalty, if Manhattanville does not score, will spill over into the third period of play. This is Taylor Hamm up ahead on the left wing side. Ashley DeFusco got turned back. Meredith on it, played it on. Howard to Meredith. Meredith, left-handed shooter. Got it on the Hamm. Hamm had it pulled off her stick and sent down by Claudia Capone. And Manhattanville's going to have to regroup with just above a minute remaining in the period. Holly Meredith from behind the net. Slips a pass on. Taken by Howard. Played up through center ice. Interrupted by Capone as she predicted nicely. And down the right wing side, Ushenko into the zone and in the high slot. Her shot, and it may have broken off the glove of Flores. Ushenko on it in the corner to the far side. Gave it away to Howard. Howard able to skate through. Chops a pass up ahead. DeFusco got bumped there, and it's going to be taken right back and moved along. Benia did a nice job, knocked it out. Got another penalty upcoming here to the Bantams with the arm up. And it's behind the play. It's a cross-checking call. And it's going to go against Trinity College. We're going to see a two-man advantage now for Manhattanville. With 26 seconds remaining in the period. So they'll have a two-man advantage for 43 seconds, which will move on to period number three. If they don't score, cross-check is going to be the call. Virgin Robinia picking up the infraction. So you got two in the penalty box. Taylor Foy will step out in 42 seconds, she hopes. Puck chopped down at the line by Pelowitz. Pelowitz plays it over to Howard. Back to Pelowitz in the high slot. Dropped it to the circle. A pass on through. Blocked away. Pelowitz with a drive. Saved by the goalkeeper, Stephanie Garvis. And the puck is sent out to center ice. Lopez with that nice little soft pass to Pelowitz there. Set up the one-timer. As the horn will sound and we move on to the third period. And a great work by Stephanie Garvis, the freshman goalkeeper for Trinity. Coming up with a couple of big saves here in the second period. Lena Flores likewise. They'll step off the ice tied at one. And there will be a two-man power play opportunity for Manhattanville in the third for 16 seconds to start the period on a fresh sheet of ice. All right, we'll take a break. 1-1, you score. Back with stats in a bit. Back here at the Williams Rink. Both teams tied at one, Manhattanville and Trinity College. Manhattanville will have a two-man power play opportunity to begin the third for some, I think, 16 seconds or so. Looking at some of the statistical information through two periods of play and the scoring recap, obviously, in the first period at 11-17. Manhattanville scored at even strength. Tiana Lopez from Amanda Sabia. And that made it 1-0. It remained that way to 4:03 of period number two when Martha Pepis scored from Mia Fusco to tie it up for Trinity College. So each team has scored a goal. 1-1 your score. Shots on goal through two periods in favor of Trinity. 23-14 over Manhattanville. Manhattanville enjoying yet another power play opportunity. They'll be working on their fifth when time expires on the first penalty. You got Foy coming out of the penalty box first. Cobinia will remain in as they need to set the timepiece, which they haven't done as of yet. Face-off victories in favor of Trinity now, 20-11. So they have dominated in that area. Sierra Lee has won 8, and Karina Cave Hopkins has won 9 faceoffs. Amanda Sabia has won 7 for Manhattanville here in the game. So they'll set those penalty clocks and then we'll get things going here. Total of 6 shots on goal by Manhattanville on the power play here tonight. Total of 4 and 3 tries for Trinity. And they still haven't set the clock yet. Block shots, 12 by Manhattanville tonight, and only 4 for Trinity. And they still haven't set the clock yet. They'll do that now, I would imagine. That's why we have a delay before we start the third period. This game started 7:30 tonight. It certainly has been entertaining. Rather comfortable temperatures inside the Williams Rink tonight here on the campus of Trinity College. Third consecutive home game for the Bantams. Won their first of the season versus Johnson and Wales. They're beaten by number 7 Norwich here at home. And now they have it up there. Yep, 16 seconds remaining on the first penalty to Taylor Foy. 1:24 remaining on the infraction to Virgin Corbinia. So Corbinia had a strong game defensively here tonight. We'll have to watch for the sin bin along with Foy. So two defensemen are in the penalty box right now. 3 lonely skaters in front of the goaltender, Stephanie Garvey. She's down to our right. Lena Flores to our left for Manhattanville. And we're underway here in the third. And this is a crucial opportunity, crucial moment. And the puck slapped down. And it's going to be offside. It's ruled against Manhattanville in the faceoff coming outside the Trinity blue line. Sabia to take the faceoff, going up against Karina Cave Hawkins. Hawkins has done a terrific job winning faceoffs today. This time it's won by Sabia back to Lopez and onto the left wing side to Zoe Pelowitz. Pelowitz will slow it down. 2-man advantage, slips a pass to the doorstep and it's tipped just wide of the goal by Sabia, who was left unattended. Well-designed play right there. Foy is back on the ice, out of the penalty box, so it's now 5-on-4. Puck comes into the high slot. Fusco will control it for Trinity and send it on down. Trinity in the home white uniforms, if you're just tuning in, Manhattanville in their away blues with the white numerals. 52 seconds remaining on the Cobinia penalty. Off the left wing side is Zoo. Pass got deflected along and stolen away by Mia Fusco and slapped down ice. Flores will leave it in the corner. Good job by the Bantams on the penalty kill. They have survived the 2-man disadvantage. Now just 30 seconds remaining on the penalty to Cobinia. This is McNeely. Ragging time off that penalty clock. In the corner. Get bumped around. It's going to be taken away by Zoe Pelowitz. Pelowitz stops. Falls down. Gets up. And got a penalty upcoming here going against Pelowitz for a hold, holding the hockey stick of Cassidy McNeely. That's going to even things up on the ice for the next 11 seconds, and then we'll see a minute 49 of power play time for the Bantams. It'll be their fourth power play. Manhattanville now 0-for-5 on their power play tries. So Pelowitz picking up the penalty for holding the stick. McNeely to take this faceoff. Great job on the forecheck on the penalty kill by McNeely. She wins the puck into the corner. Tied up by Meredith. Puck comes on back to Julia Lee and a quick snap on goal and Flores will hold. Good wrist shot coming from the blue line there. And that's a whale of a shift by Cassidy McNeely. As she comes off the ice, Kaitlyn Flaherty out there. Actually, McNeely's going to stay out. He's had a long shift. Trying to win this faceoff. Kicked it on. Along the far side. When Steinberg's at control, the power play is underway. A minute 40 remaining on the penalty clock. Bantams have never led in this game. They trailed 1-0, tied it in the second. McNeely, what a shift she has had. Played it on. knocked down hard in the corner with Sierra Lee. And we get a whistle. Face-off upcoming. Penalty upcoming. Roughing will be the call. Holly Meredith will go to the penalty box, and now a two-man advantage for the Bantams. They'll have a 1 minute and 29 seconds of two-man power play advantage time. So Pelowitz joined by Meredith in the penalty box. And a chance for the Bantams to break this game wide open. As we mentioned, they have never led here tonight. Sierra Lee, who's been good on faceoff, wins it to the far wall. Slip back to the line. Martson will keep it in. Got it on to Lee. Lee controlling along the wall. Played it smartly back to the line to Von Steinberg. Von Steinberg carries. Holds. High slot. Snaps it on left side to Flaherty. Flaherty back on. Martson hit a goal post as it was redirected on the doorstep by McNeely. Second time they've hit a post. They hit a crossbar back in the second. Von Steinberg off to the right circle. Taken in by Sierra Lee. Wheels it to the front. Knocked away. Played off the glass. Martson will keep it in with hustle. Played it onto the far side. Lee to control. Von Steinberg steps in. Drives one. Scores! On the power play. Kamelli Von Steinberg gives the Bantams their first lead of the game. With a good shot from the blue line. That is her third goal of the season. And the young lady out of the grand state of Minnesota puts one on the board. The sophomore playing in her 52nd game. That is her fourth career goal. So one penalized player, that Zoe Pelowitz, will come back. Holly Meredith will remain in the penalty box. 1:17 remaining on her penalty. As your score is now 2-1. No announcement on who did score the goal, but it certainly looked like it was Von Steinberg's all the way. There was a Bantam on the doorstep trying to redirect. Cassidy McNeely, my opinion, over the last 90 seconds has made it all work with her great play for the Bantams. And they lead it for the first time at 2-1. It will be Von Steinberg's goal. Marston and Lee will pick up the helpers. So Sierra Lee and Katie Martson, the helpers on the Camille Von Steinberg's goal. So 2-1. Puck thrown back into the Manhattanville zone. On the left wing side, Ushenko got it back to the line. Off to the right. Simpson snapped it into the slot. Battle for it there. Skated away Wilhelmsen now. Simpson from the blue line, shot on. Glove saved by Flores, played it off to the corner. Off the glass, comes back to Simpson. Simpson played it off. And we get a whistle offside. That puck must have come out of the zone. 46 seconds remaining on the power play here for the Bantams. They tried to increase the lead, looking for an insurance goal as they garner their first lead with a power play goal here in the third. Kamelli Von Steinberg's with the tally to make it 2-1, their third of the season. Martson, one of the helpers. Cross ice pass to Flaherty, will skate it in. Flaherty into the slot, shot blocked away. Sierra Lee, who also picked up a helper on the power play goal, got it back to the line and hopped over the stick of Von Steinberg's and is taken out of the near side by Katie Martston. Martston in. Martson carries to the corner. McNeely floats to the front of the net. Puck play to the far side. To the line, Von Steinberg played it back off. Lee, blue line, Martson shot just wide. Rebound, big rebound, came off the wall of the circle and shot wide by Sierra Lee. Now it's Flaherty, slap shot, and we get another whistle on that block shot, and boy, that had to hurt somewhat. Faceoff will be inside the Manhattanville zone. Got a penalty for interference upcoming to Katie Marston. Came away from the play. So that's going to give Manhattanville a power play in just 3 seconds and also have an offensive zone faceoff here. A lot of penalties being whistled here early in the third period with 16:06 left. Manhattanville's going to have their sixth opportunity on the power play. Crucial faceoff upcoming. Karina Cave Hawkins to take the faceoff for the Bantams, going up against Amanda Sabia. Now some questions being asked. It's going to be a 4-on-4 in front of the goaltenders for just 3 seconds, and the power play will begin for Manhattanville as Holly Meredith will step out of the penalty box. Off the faceoff, controlled by the Bantams and sent down ice by Mia Fusco. Nice job by Fusco in collaboration with Cave Hawkins in that crucial faceoff win. Power play is underway now for Manhattanville, trailing 2-1. Comes up the right wall to Lopez. Lopez, the goal scorer for Manhattanville today, into the high slot on the backhand. Save made by Garvis and played it off to the corner. Puck thrown up ice and over the stick of Pelowitz. Now it comes a chase after that loose puck. It's Fusco first on it to the corner. Pelowitz stays right with her. Fusco trying to just pin it along the wall, take valuable time off the penalty. Got knocked down on the play. Taken away by Zoo. Played up ahead it comes. Off the right wing, Sabia into the middle of Lopez. Lopez to the backhand side into the corner, being harassed there by Simpson. Good job by Simpson to tie her up along the wall. Zoo in the help out from Manhattanville. Finally taken away and controlled by Tittman. Put it side of the goal and Zoo couldn't do much with it and scaled back down ice the other way by Alex Simpson, who's had a strong game here today. Down under 1 minute remaining on the power play for Manhattanville, and they've had a whole slew of chances, including a two-man advantage here in this contest. They have yet to score a power play goal in this sixth try. Puck is loose to the far side. Going to be stolen away into the high slot. Good job by Mushenko. She's had a strong game today. On to McNeely. McNeely, side of the goal, got tied up. Puck knocked off for his stick, and Pelowitz will regain possession. Played it off left wing side to Ham. Tangled up in her skates, and an easy play. Corbini able to drop it back down into the Manhattanville zone. Julia Lee holds her ground at the blue line and pokes it deeper into the Manhattanville zone, down to just 6 seconds remaining on a power play that really never got going. This is Taylor Ham goes cross ice to Howard. Howard carries into the zone. Howard trying to turn it past Lee, threw it in on a netminder. Garvis made the save, rebound far side. Flaherty hurries it up the center ice, and here's a break down the right wing by Pepis. She's tallied here today. Pepis with a shot, save is made by Flores, and she'll cover. 13:51 remaining here in the third period, still 2-1, the Bantams on top. Well, the folks certainly enjoying the action down below. They've been into this. Hope you're enjoying at home, wherever you might be watching around the world on the World Wide Web. Puck skated away from Harm in front. Vandalin's trying to get back to her skates. Got some help there from Lanny Nash. Played along the wall and knocked out the center by DeFusco. Taken in return by Flaherty. Knocked off her stick. And this is controlled by Nash again. Pass never found its mark, and it turned back into the Manhattanville zone. Lanny Nash from behind the net will slow things down. Nash being pressured. Nearly turned it over. She will. This is Flaherty on the steal. Played it into the corner to McKeon. McKeon poked at it there, got knocked down on the play, did McKeon. She'll get back up. Flaherty has the puck and played it back to the line to Simpson. Back to Flaherty. Flaherty had it knocked off her stick on the long reach of Clark, and the puck will slide out to center ice. That's where Simpson controls now at her own line. Played on and tipped on by Ford. Chased down by McNeely into the corner. McNeely on it there. Sandal is trying to take it away. Comes back to the line right side to Foy. Foy into the circle. Pepis just couldn't dig. Actually, that was Mushenko. Just couldn't dig it out of her skates. And it's sent down by Manhattanville for one of the rare icing calls here today. Haven't had many icing calls at all. 12:35 remaining here in the third. And you got a 2-1 game in favor of the home team, Trinity College. McNeely will take the faceoff. Oh, before we get that, we're going to get a timeout. It's going to be taken by Manhattanville. So we'll rest the vocal cords for just a moment. 2-1 your score. Go ahead, goal scored here in the third period by Kamelli von Steinbergs. With the assist going to Katie Marston and Sierra Lee on the power play. Just 2:39 into the third period. All right, timeout is over. Faceoff coming to the left of the Manhattanville goalkeeper, Lena Flores, who's been very busy here tonight. Trinity College out shooting Manhattanville. We're at even strength right now with 12 and a half left. Team in the white uniform, Trinity College with the lead at 2-1. Long pass by Simpson, played off on the left wing side, scurrying into the zone. Off the left wing is Wilhelmsen, a shot, and Flores got a piece of it. Wilhelmsen with a good rush coming off the near wall here. On at McNeely. McNeely grinds into the corner. McNeely drops it off into the skates of Mushenko. Mushenko back to the line of Foy. Tees one up and that's blocked. Foy will hustle to keep it in at the blue line and slip it along to the far corner where Nash takes it. Nash played it along to Lopez. Lopez gave it away. Now it's midpoint and Foy can't keep it in. Has to retreat out the neutral lines. Off to her partner on the far side. That's Simpson. Simpson wheeling nicely. Skates up ice with a head up over the red line. She'll drop it in. And the forward line will change on the fly for Trinity College. Kept in by Fusco with those fresh skates. Played it off to the far side. First one to it there is Nash. Nash double team. Pepis couldn't take it away. Yana Lopez, who has scored the only goal for Manhattanville, couldn't get it out. It's kept in. They had numbers down low, but electing to take the shot was Cave Hawkins. Rather easy save for Flores there in a faceoff upcoming. 2-1, you score. Trinity on top. Story of the game has been the Bantam's penalty-killing unit. 0-6 is Manhattanville. And on the flip side, with a two-man advantage, the Bantams took advantage and scored a power play goal for the 2-1 lead. Cave Hawkins will keep it in, but swept off her stick. Holly Meredith worked it up the board. Good pinch along the wall there by Capone to keep it in. Now to Cave Hawkins on behind. Separated from the puck and it slides on to Allie Howard for Manhattanville and played out to center ice. Going to slide all the way down into the Trinity College end. Von Steinberg's on it there. She scored the go-ahead goal on the power play. She's on behind the net. Having a great start to the season with three goals. In just three games. This is Sierra Lee with a shot and it breaks off of Flores. Good job by Sierra Lee to use the body to find the angle to drive that. Back comes Ham the other way. Ham in, poked away at the last moment by Claudia Capone. Puck back out the center ice. Sierra Lee drops it and looks for the line change. Right now, the Bantams making quick line changes, looking for their second win of the season coming into today's play at 1-1, Manhattanville coming in with three up. They've won three in a row. 3-1-1 overall. Again, the Bantams just going to lockdown mode at their defensive blue line. Back across, off the left side, Bornstein. couldn't do much with it that time. Manhattanville will send it back out to center ice. Pass intercepted. Fabini, a nice job there to read that play. Now she deflects a long pass intended for Clark, and the puck will dribble in on Garbus, who alertly ties it up for a faceoff. 9:41 left here in the third period. So the faceoff coming to the right-hand side of Stephanie Garbus, the freshman netminder, has certainly held her own in her debut. Puck out to center ice, Flaherty. Down the right wing, has speed, breaks it all alone. Shot, save, Flores! Oh, and she'll tie it up for a faceoff. Beautiful rush by Kaylin Flaherty. And Lena Flores able to make the stop equal to the challenge. Bantam looking for that insurance goal here. Only like opponent between these two teams, Johnson and Wales. Trinity College beat them. Manhattanville tied them and beat them. Played them a back-to-back game to start the season. Puck up ahead. Stolen at center ice. Martson will drive it right back into that Manhattanville zone to the far side of the forecheck, Flaherty. Puck squirts along to the near corner to Clark. Clark will quickly throw it up ice and found a stick. Not much going on as the Bantam just clog up their blue line. Meredith played it on to Clark, poked away. Flaherty did not recognize that Katie Martson was still in the offensive zone, and that's an offside against Trinity College. 8:59 remaining in the period. Manhattanville and Trinity. Trinity has scored two consecutive goals to take the lead here after falling behind 1-0. Puck chopped back down to the Trinity College end for an icing call against Manhattanville. Face-off upcoming again to the right of the goaltender, Alina Flores. Well, at this point in the game, it comes down to conditioning and will. At the drop, Manhattanville will control it. Howard couldn't get it up the wall. McNeely was looking after it. Taken away by Braden James and played on to the right wing side to Sabia. Sabia carries to the corner, shovels a backhand pass in front on the far post. Lopez slapped at it, and Garvis went post to post to make the save. Sabia with a beautiful pass on the backhand side from the corner there. Lopez was looking for her second of the night. Scored her first of the season way back in the first period now. Karina Cave Hawkins, who's been reliable, taking faceoffs for Trinity, will win yet another from Lopez that time. Turning with it is Capone, played it off smartly. Good breakout. Schenko moves it up ahead. This is Fusco. Fusco, centering pass, deflected right back behind the goal. Players scurry after it. Trying to shovel the one in front was Fusco, and that was turned back. James on the rush played it off to Lopez up ahead, looking for Sabia. Sabia was well guarded by Claudia Capone and finds open space as she rounds the net. Capone, smart pass on to Hawkins. Hawkins over the red line will just dribble it on down and look for a line change. Down to 7:48 remaining here in the third period, 2-1. Trinity College with the advantage that the puck is out to center ice, and that's Julia Lee. Carries into the zone, but a little tardy out of the zone was Martha Pepis, who scored the game's first, her first of the season. Faceoff coming just outside the Valance blue line. Off the draw. Manhattanville will control it. Pelowitz got it to the line, but kept in. Good job there by defense of the Bantam. Bobinia threw it in front again. The backhander score. Sierra Lee. Bobby Kobinina did a nice job there keeping it at the blue line, and that led to the goal by Sierra Lee, her first of the game. Virgin Kobinina, nice job. Tell you what, when your defenseman can make that calculated risk and keep the puck in, the heat stays on, doesn't it? Kobinina did a nice job sending it down low, and Lee with the tally to make it 3-1 here. Here's a shot. Went wide. Gavis might have got a little piece of that. Puck back to the line, into the corner it goes, and on behind the net. Zhu got tied up in a little knot. Taken there by Sierra Lee, who just scored moments ago. Give the Bantam the two-goal advantage here with 6:41 remaining. Julia Lee to the near side. Pass comes all the way to center ice. On the far side, stolen away by Core and played down ice. This is Lanny Nash, played it back down into the Trinity College end. It should go the length of the ice, and it will for an icing call. So get the official word on that goal here. Put it up on the website. Now it's coming your way. Yep. Sierra Lee with the tally. Bornstein's going to pick up the helper along with Kobinia. Players collide out by the blue line. Looks like DeFusco took the worst of that as she's slow to get up, and we'll get a whistle behind the play to make sure she's all right. So Ashley DeFusco took a pretty good wallop there. Players just colliding. Incidental. And she's up and she's back to the bench on the far side. .559 remaining here in the third period. Anna Tittman to take this face off, going up against McKeon. Puck knocked out to center ice. Howard will collect it, dribble the pass on the backhand side, up ahead to Tittman. Tittman got it on, long shot up off the glass. Capone maneuvers it up ice, nice pass on. Martson goes cross ice, and it did find the tape eventually of Flaherty. Now back in her own zone, one Steinbergs played it off to the near side, left to Capone. That defensive pairing has done a nice job tonight for Trinity. Puck's on the way on the far side by Ham. Ham into the corner, able to lean away from Flaherty, but gave up possession. And back the other way comes Bailey McKeon, and she'll send it on down into the Manhattanville end. 3-1 your score. Kept in at the blue line by Simpson. Played on to McNeely. Centering pass intercepted in front by Howard. Carried onto the far side. Puck swatted at. It's getting late at night. Everybody's starting to get a little bit tired. I'm getting tired too. It's been a long day today. A lot of work. Now it's off to the far side to Simpson. Simpson snaps it in on goal. Nice save made by Flores. A rebound was left there. McNeely just couldn't pull the trigger on it. What a third period McNeely has had today for the Bantams. 3-1 your score. Puck kept it on the far side by Mushenko. Angelica Mushenko has also played a solid game. It's really been a wonderful team effort put together by the Bantams. Manhattanville running out of gas as they ice it once again. You can just see it down below being worn down by the Bantams. Their attack has really been tenacious throughout here tonight. Faceoff wins belong to Manhattanville in the first period. Through two, a big differential in favor of Trinity. So really that part of the game has helped to wear down Manhattanville as they've been chasing a lot here tonight. Puck into the corner. Martha Pepis, who scored the first goal for the Bantams. Tried to center it in front. Was knocked away. Captain at the line, Von Steinbergs, who's just been sensational, scored the goal, head goal here in the third on the power play. Down in the corner to Martha Pepis. Pepis trying to work it along with Fusco. And back to Capone, snaps it on, and Flores will find it, and she'll hold for the faceoff. Two goals here in the third. And Steinberg's tally, and then Sierra Lee's score to open up a 3-1 lead. 3:58 remaining here in the third period. Cave Hawkins to take the offensive draw, going up against Sabia. Amanda Sabia has really been fun to watch here tonight. She has done a heck of a job for Manhattanville. Lopez, who has scored her squad's only goal, is at puck out of play. Faceoff coming back inside the Manhattanville zone as it went into the bench. Amanda Sabia talking about Amanda from Freehold, New Jersey in the gunnery school. Puck in the corner. Brenna Hoare had it just momentarily. Now it's back to the line. Capone will snap it on. Van Steinberg's shot knocked down. Pelowitz played it far side. Now she'll try to lead the attack. Got tripped up and a penalty upcoming. It's going to go against Claudia Capone. As she hooked her down, and the faceoff will be deep inside the Trinity College zone. And the last gasp of hope upcoming here for Manhattanville with their seventh power play of the night. They are 0-6. Faceoff to the right of Stephanie Garvis. Off the faceoff. Another win for Cave Hawkins. Pellets will keep it in at the left point. Creeps in, hold, played it on. Lopez playing the right point on the power play. Diagonal pass, far side. Taken there by Zoo. Zoo to Lopez, snaps it on, and it goes in. The score. Broke off the goaltender Stephanie Garvis in a power play tally for Manhattanville with 3:02 left. They've made it 3-2. Oh, that's one Garvis might like to have back. It just broke right through her. And I guess from the perspective of Manhattanville, it's about time. They finally tally on the power play. That stops a run of three consecutive goals put together by Trinity. Off the faceoff, control, Manhattanville. He'll send it on in. And Steinberg just ran into the official and led to the break and a pass in front for DeFusco. Good to see her back on the ice. She got banged up earlier. Racing down, the right wing is Flaherty. Knocked off her stick by Holly Meredith. Quickly throws it out to center. But Steinberg's are there. She'll carry back in. Poked off her stick neatly by Lopez. Lead pass up ahead for Sabia. Sabia into the zone, got Lopez with her. Sabia's dangerous, cuts down low, base in a circle, snaps it off, save is made. On the rebound is Zoo. Back to the line to Meredith, tees it up and drives one just wide through a screen. The rebound off the back wall, poked at and covered by Garvis. 2:27 left, the goalkeeper Flores will start to watch her down to our left-hand side. Off the faceoff, comes back to Meredith, on over to Howard. Howard played it behind the net. Sabia got knocked down, puck taken away, and safely played out to center ice. Good job there by Corbinia to work that puck out of the zone. Now she's being chased down, but the icing call will come with a faceoff back inside the Manhattanville zone. Yep, Manhattanville scores. It's going to go to Tiana Lopez, that's her second of the game, and another assist for Sabia, her second, and Janet Zhu will also pick up a helper on that power play tally. So each team has scored a power play goal here tonight now. Time of that goal was 16:58. Off the faceoff, it's controlled by the Bantams, down under 2 minutes left. They'll try to keep the pressure on now in the offensive zone and not allow Manhattanville to pull that goalkeeper. Puck sent up ahead. Capone trying to keep it in. It hopped over his stick. So it's chased down by Fusco. Fusco maneuvers past one. Now she skates up ice and into the zone, into the slot, to the circle. Fusco holding into the corner. Fusco on behind, and that centered it off the stick of Pepis and back the other way. On the rush comes Taylor Ham. Ham got ridden off by Capone. Ham stays with it and shovels it side of the net. Behind the goal, Clark digging after. Goalkeeper out. 1:21 remaining. Extra attacker is on, and Manhattanville's got a hurt player. That's Clark behind the play. And we'll get a whistle, and slow to get up after the awkward fall is Adele Clark. I believe it's going to take the faceoff outside the zone. Maybe that wasn't Clark. That could have been Taylor Ham that took the awkward fall, 11 and not 15. Faceoff will come outside the zone. So that's a big break for Trinity College here with 1:14 left. They have not put the goalkeeper back in. Pelowitz is claiming, why isn't the faceoff inside the zone? And she's not going to win that battle. Goaltender remains out. That's Lena Flores. Extra attacker on the ice surface for Manhattanville. They'll win this crucial draw. Lopez, who has scored twice here today, finds a trailer. Quick shot. Darvison, rebound on the doorstep. She got that too as Sabia rapped at it. Couple of chances there. Open net. Up ice comes Fusco. Takes a shot just wide of the goal as she had scampered over that red line. So there's no icing call. Smart play there. Puck back out to center ice. Played around the rim of the wall by Von Steinberg to the far side, down to 40 seconds left. Manhattanville trying to get it out of their zone. Tipped along by Lopez. Sabia couldn't reach it, along with Zhu. Pelowitz will play it, taken by Zhu. Zhu got tangled up, knocked down and offside. Is Trinity College at the line, 23 seconds left, and boy, a faceoff win here could just about ice it for him. It has been a fun one. 3-2 your score. Diana Lopez with a pair of goals for Manhattanville. Three different scores tonight for Trinity College. 17 seconds left. Howard from behind her net. Manhattanville's going to have to hurry up now. They just play it out to center ice. Waiting for it there was Alex Simpson. Simpson able to dig it back into that Manhattanville zone. Stolen away by McNeely. Shot it towards net, knocked away. As the horn will sound and the Banthams are going to win their second of the season. They'll improve to 2-1 with the victory here tonight over Manhattanville. So they make it just a one-game losing streak when they lost 4-1 to Norwich to come back here today in their third consecutive home game. The Bantams victorious in a non-conference matchup with Manhattanville. Manhattanville's going to drop to 3-2. Recapping the scoring very quickly for you, Manhattanville jumped out on top on the first period at 11-17. Deanna Lopez, the first of two here tonight, picking up the goal. Amanda Sabia had the assist. Then Trinity went on a three-goal run. Their first goal in the second period at 4:03 as Martha Pepis scored. Mia Fusco picked up the helper, tying it at one. In the third period with a two-man advantage at 2:39, the go-ahead goal, it was scored by Kamelli von Steinberg. And the assist went to Katie Martson and Sierra Lee. Manhattanville would score the insurance goal. That was a go-ahead goal at the time. And then Sierra Lee scored from Bronstein and Kobinia. at 12:47. That would be the eventual game winner. You had that late goal by Manhattanville, made it interesting, 16:58 of the third, the second of the game by Lopez, Sabia, and Zoo picking up the helpers. All right, that's going to do it right here from Trinity College inside the Williams Rink. Your final score for the final time, Trinity College 3 and Manhattanville 2. Thanks for tuning in to Trinity College Ice Hockey. Goodbye. Good night, everybody.